at the other end of this very wet and waterlogged pitch are the other semi-finalists this afternoon, West Ham United. And it's West Ham kicking off in this semi-final tie here at Hillsborough against Manchester United. West Ham playing in their normal colour of the Cambridge blue, and Manchester United in the all-white strip this afternoon. The conditions a very long way from being perfect. Very heavy, dull, overcast sky, raining intermittently, and a very wet, heavy waterlogged pitch to play. Hurst just managing to keep it in play. And that's a difficult one there, and a great save there by Gaskell. A tremendous save there by Gaskell. He was nearly caught unawares, but Sissons with the corner. It's a bit too hard. Best not able to get it away, but Sethers, I think, will and does. And a throw into West Ham United. They'll get back to Moore. He hits his own voice back in the back of the net, and it's Charlton. Punching across a lovely pass there to Sissel. Bond in too hard, and it's Quirin now, putting it on out to Best. Best trying a shot there, and it's a wonderful save there by Stanton. In fact, he did save it. It hit the bar. I thought, in fact, that he saved it. And I missed Stokes in the side that I'm wrong on both counts. In fact, an offside against Law. That is what I thought it was a foul, but the referee has waved play on. Burn to Hurst. Hurst to Sissons. And there is a foul against Sissons there. You probably can see him pushing, but holding his face, I suppose he would want to run into the back of Brennan's elbow as he was trying to go forward there. But Brennan's took the free kick for Manchester United. Eventually, Law that just dollars it back to Brennan to take his time. How about finding someone to play it to? And there's Chisnell. Bollington late there, but still with Law. Law for Manchester United, the skipper of the Manchester United side. And just wasn't going then with the pass that Law made for it. Standing onto the head of Dunn. It's Moore. Across to Hurst. Hurst! Trying the impossible there, really, not even setting the eye of a needle through a very wet and boggy pitch is a difficult enough job, but an impossibility against the Manchester United defenceless. Or punching it well cleared up and up to Bobbington, not up to quick enough, but it's Chisnell to Quirin. Oh, and a bad pass there by Quirin, puts West Ham right back in the picture, and it's Braidbrook. Tackled out of it by Charlton. Nothing at all wrong in that tackle, and that's Quirin there. Quirin just Moore didn't go, but he's going now and going very quickly. Just pushed back quite calmly. Burn again, this heavy ground. Setters trying a tremendous dip there at it, but didn't quite get his shot in. Done to Charlton, and undoubtedly now Manchester United right on top of this stage. Push through there. Law climbs it up, and it's Birkin. A very, very good piece of play there by Birkin. Right under pressure. No, it's not Birkin, it's Moore. These two blonde boys look very much alike at this distance. But typical of Moore, of course, under pressure, no panic. And it's Burn to Braybrook. Again, the pace off the pitch beating Braybrook, and a throw in to Manchester United. Done back to Settles. Setters, Bollington, to They're done. Pushing it away. That'll be a throw-in to West Ham. Back it comes to Moore. Centres up. And, of course, does the exact thing that he should do under circumstances. I'm not just straight behind for a corner to West Ham. Great Brook then with the corner for West Ham. On balance, West Ham have had more corners than Manchester United, but have not yet turned them any advantage. Let's see what this happens with this one. And it's first, I think, yes. The cannon that one past the post. They better nearly turn it provided that time. Manchester United kicking off in the second half with the score still 0-0. And they, I think, for my money, have been slightly the better side in this first half. The standard of football has been remarkably good considering the very bad conditions of the ground here. But this is no fault, of course, of the Sheffield Wednesday grounds, but just the fact that it's rained so very heavily and it's still raining now as the game is going on. I think we'll have to see a little bit more action from the West Ham forwards if they're going to penetrate this very strong Manchester United defence in the second half. Gaskell taking the goal kick for Manchester United. Pushed on by Byrne. Oh, that's Charlton there. Charlton getting onto it. And this may be the first one. Oh, and it's whipped past the post. My goodness me. In fact, it just touched the post as it went past and heard. But there was a mistake there between Bond and Stanton. Although I must say that Bovington got caught flat-footed in the mud out of that. So we really can't blame anybody other than the mud for that mishap in the West Ham job. Centre back, but there's Braidbrook onto it. Braidbrook having to wait now because there's nobody across there. It's a corner kick, in fact, off the arm of Dunford. No appeal for handball. Corner kick then to West Ham. Still no score. Brand comes up and it's first. It goes slightly askew there. Sissons. It's charged out by a complete wall of Manchester United players there. And bested it. Comes away with the ball, makes a present of it, straight to Birkin. Birkin. Byrne gets his head to it, but it's been pushed straight back again to Best, and it's with Law now. Law. Manchester United now undoubtedly getting well on top in the second half. Finds Hurd. Hurd clipping it through there. Charlton is Best. And the pace off the floor beat him once again. Second half is only 10 minutes old, but again, West Ham under pressure from this Manchester United side. West Ham throw going to Byrne. Throwing to West Ham United. Bond, I think, will trot up and take it. This will give West Ham an additional forward to play around with, or additional man up in attack. Up to now they haven't used this to any advantage. Byrne just cutting it off there. Bond to Braidbrook. Braidbrook to Bond. Bond chopping it into the centre. Hurst getting it down. And a fair old pile up of players there, and I think Setters is alright. Yes, he's up on his feet. He's a pretty tough customer, it's Setters. Boyce. And there's the first one. Boyce it is. 11 minutes gone in the second half, and it's Boyce, a clockwork man they call him at West Ham, that put West Ham, I must say, against the run of play, 1-0 in the lead. Now the fight is undoubtedly really on. But of course it may also have the effect on West Ham, in as much as young Clifford here, who's had a very quiet game so far, might come into the picture. Certainly is. Well, he's overrun it there, the same as Byrne has done so many times, and it's Manchester United now, storming back into the attack. Long raking pass there, Brown onto it, throw in for Manchester United. Graham hooking it in there. Might well have been a penalty for Bond, Charlton, and it's Boyce that gets it away. The Best. Best. And it's past the front end of the post for a goal kick to West Ham. Stanton's goal kick for West Ham. Wonderful run there by Brennan. A superb run there by Brennan to place himself up with Burkett. What a wonderful piece of good thinking by Brennan there to save the line ball in a second goal. And it's corner kick now to West Ham. Burkett.
Because the time to be
it on, but say about 10 minutes left for play. Well, West Ham then, two clear goals in the lead again. Graham banging it well clear. But the opposition centre half is pushing it up now to clear. What a tremendous battle this has been. Wonderful football played in some really atrocious conditions. It's all the more proud of these two players, two teams rather, that we've seen virtually no haziness or panicness at all in the whole of this 90 minutes. And there is the final whistle. The West Ham United have beaten Manchester United 3-1 here this afternoon, and they'll be at Wembley on May the 2nd. The first half it was undoubtedly Manchester United who were far the better side. And in the second half, after Joyce just got his head to a football, put one goal into the